So just share the screen. So all of you are getting this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So first we'll go to start mechanical design and part design. So now we'll see how to create multi-section solids. Suppose if you want to create helical gear or different profile gears. So here, and give okay. Okay. So note down some of the points to create multi-section solids. Here we have multi-section solids. So first, to create multi-section solids, first point. All of you are getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, first, create more than two different profiles. Create more than two different profiles on a different parallel planes. On a different parallel planes. On a two different parallel planes. Second point. Minimum two guidelines should be drawn. Minimum two guidelines should be drawn. Minimum two guidelines should be drawn. Next, closing points should be aligned. Closing points should be aligned. Okay, so three points we need to follow.
Rending and another, sir.
Multi-section solids. See here. To create this multi-section solids, we need to follow these three points. Okay, first is we need to create three different profiles on a different parallel planes. See, first we need to create three parallel planes. So see, to create parallel planes, here we have reference elements. See, reference elements. So here in this we have plane, okay? So select this plane. So once you select this plane, suppose if you want to create parallel plane to this top plane, so select the top plane. So once you select the top plane, so here you just click on this offset and you can move, okay? So what I will do, I will give distance as 100, okay? So that this is one plane, this is another plane. One more plane I will create. Select this. Same, I will see, you can select this or this. So I will select this. So same as 100. Okay. Fine. So we had to create three different profiles. So what I will do, I will select this and I will go to sketch, position sketch. Okay. So go to position sketch. Yeah. So here I will show you this example hexagon. So this is how we can create helical gear. So this is, I'm going to rotate with this. I'm going to coincide with this horizontal axis. Then select this. So I will give distance as 100. Okay. So once you create it, again you have to exit. Where is that exit button? Yeah. So where is that? It is in on right. So it will hide here sometimes. So where is that? Okay, in that case you can reset this toolbar. So how? Just right click it, go to customize here. So once you go to customize, so here go to toolbar, see restore all contents, click on restore all contents, give okay, then restore position and give okay. So now you will get everything. See, you just place it here. So I'll close this. So here, see here you are getting one symbol, right? Light color. Take this out. So just place it here. So here you have workbench, okay? So if you want to place it here, you can place it here and exit workbench. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, only three members has attended. Where is another two guys?
No idea, sir.
Okay, you just click on exit workbench. Once you click on exit workbench, so again, what I will do, I will select this plane and I will go to position sketch. Okay, same position, see. So now, what I will do, I will set the same and I will create. I am not coinciding right now here. So I am just rotating it, okay. So this I will give distance as 75. Now, 75, okay. Next, this rotation, I will give as 20. See now, it's a different profile we have created. See, next I will select same this plane, parallel plane, and I will go to sketch. Again, I will create this. So now also I'm not going to coincide. So now I will give distance this as 50. Okay. Now I will rotate this and this angle with 40. See now, exit. See now, how you are getting. So all of you got it. Any doubts so yes. far?
No.
Okay, wait. See here. Any doubts? So next.
No, sir.
So see, first point we have fulfilled, right? So one more thing, you can hide these planes if you want. Select this, right click and hide. Again, select this, right click and hide. Okay, see now, you just observe here. We need to create three, minimum two guidelines, right? Second point. So with respect to these points, we need to create smooth guideline. So in part design, we can't able to create smooth curve, smooth guideline, because we will get only line here. So to create smooth guideline, we need to go to start, mechanical design. Here we have wireframe and surface design. Okay. So click on this wireframe and surface design. Once you click on this, so here, if you go to insert, if you go to wireframe, here you have spline. Select the spline and start creating it. So carefully you need to create. Sorry. So I'll click, just click outside. You'll get shortcut here. 1, 2, and 3. See, smooth guideline we have created. And give OK. So once you give OK, again we need to select this. So 1, 2, and 3. See, two guidelines we have created. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Again, once you create guidelines, you need to go to mechanical design and part design. See? Okay. Now, so go to multi-section solids here. Once you go to multi-section solids, see here, first sections, click on this, section 1. So same area you need to select, section 2, section 3, see. Then click on this guide, select this guide and this guide. Okay. Next, third point we have, closing point should be aligned. See, this closing point should lie on this guideline, or else, see here, it has been aligned, right, with respect to these points. Sometimes what happens, closing point will be like this. See here, all of you are getting, sometimes you will get closing point somewhere here. It will not be aligned. Okay, so in this case, what you can do, so right click on the closing point, click on the replace, and place it here. See here, it is moving in one direction, right? If it is in this direction, you just click on this arrow, you will get an aligned one. Or else if you want to align with respect to this guideline, right click on the closing point, replace and click. Again, right click on the closing point, replace and click. And right click on the closing point, replace, select, see? Like this also you can create, okay? So this you can make it in this direction, okay? So once you create it, you have to give just okay. See here, now you have got. Any doubts?
No, sir.
So this is how you can create multi-section solids. So next, we have removed multi-section. So if you want to see same thing, it has been added material. If you want to remove same profile, you can create here. You can create different profile here and use the same procedure. It will remove. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next, we have very important. Okay. So now we'll move to very important topic, that is operations, transformation features. See, translation, rotation not required. So here very important is mirror, rectangular pattern and circular pattern. Okay. So first we'll see mirror. So what I will do, So we'll create this exit and I will create. See here, if you want to use mirror pattern, see, you just keep in mind, if you want to use mirror rectangular pattern or circular pattern. See, suppose if you want to create more number of patterns, before creating feature which you want to be pattern, you have to use this procedure, insert boolean operation. Okay, so insert body. Okay, so you just click on insert body. Otherwise, what happens, whatever the feature you will create, that will add with this rectangular block. Okay, so if you want to mirror, it should not be like that. It should be separate entity, then only it will mirror. So go to insert and insert body. See here, new body has been created. So don't forget to do this. Select this plane and go to sketch. So here what I will do, I will create the circle, exit. So once you exit, go to pad. So give some distance. Oh, how much? Okay, see here. Now you can observe. So this is different body and this is different body. So part body is entire model. Okay. So once you mirror, once you create a pattern, you have to perform Boolean operation. I will tell you how to do that. So this is very important. If you want to mirror, you have to follow this. Insert body, then create a body, and then you can mirror it. Okay. Next. So here we have mirror. See. Go to mirror. So once you go to mirror, once you go to mirror, see here, no need to select this. Okay, or else if you want to select, you can select the mirror, select the body. See here, this is different body. If you won't insert new body, it will select the entire body, whatever you have created. Okay, that's why we need to insert body. Then we have to select this. See here. So once you select this, you need to select a plane. See here. Are you getting? And give okay. See here, you can easily mirror this. Now, so once you mirror, you need to add these new bodies to this product body, part body, right? So if you want to add this, right click on this part body, go to body to object. Here we have assemble. If you want to add, okay, see, once again I will show you. So I will use mirror this. Okay, see here, see, you can observe here difference. So right click, if you want to assemble, it will add. See here. Now, so now if you click on part body, entire body is selecting. So this is very important concept in CATIA. Okay, I will make undo. So you can assemble it, right? So if you want to remove, right click, body to object, you can remove it. So it will remove. See, all of you got it?
Yes sir.
Fine.
Yes sir.
So next. Okay. So next, we'll see how to make a rectangular pattern. Here we have rectangular pattern. Click on this. So once you click on this, defaultly, the say your object to be pattern, the current solid body. That means this body. So here we have instances in length, instances in spacing, spacing in length, instances in unequal spacing. But I will use this instances and length and instances in spacing. So instances, suppose if I want around 5 instances, length, so 20. Here we have direction. In which direction? Suppose if you want to use in this direction, so make it reverse. So total length we need to give. Here I will give around 100. See here. Okay. So total, within this 100, so 5 instances we have created, and give okay. So before giving okay, let me explain this also. Instances and spacing means, so spacing and instances. So suppose if you want to reduce the spacing, you can reduce the spacing. Okay. So spacing and length, so that leave it, that is not required. So this you can use. Next, second direction, if you want to create in this direction also, click on this direction and click this direction. So here, suppose if you want 3, see here, you can use 3 and give okay. So once you use mirror or any pattern, you have to perform Boolean operation, don't forget, okay. Otherwise, what happen if you import this model into ANSYS, so this entire in bodies, entire features will consider that as an individual entity. Sometimes you may require it should, it will be an individual body, but as of now, I will show you how to make a single body. Right click, part body, assemble. See here, now it has become a single body. So suppose if you want to remove, I will make undo. Right click, body to remove. See, like this. Got it? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. So next we will see circular pattern. So suppose if you have a circle. Exit pad, so I'll use mirror extent, I will use 3. Okay, so next I'll select this plane, so I will go to sketch. So here what I will do, I'll show you a simple thing. So you can use different profiles also. So before that we need to insert new body, right? We forgot. So insert body. So select this plane, go to sketch. So now, okay, exit. So now, go to pad, make a mirror extend, and you okay. So now, you just observe here, go to circular pattern here. See, defaultly it has been selected. Here instances and total angle. So suppose if you want 6 instances for total angle around 180 degree. So axis, you have to select this rotation. See, throughout 180 degree, 6 instances. Suppose if you want instances angular spacing, you can give angular spacing at an angle 45 degree. It will create. But here we'll use complete crown. Complete crown means throughout 360 degree, only you have to give instances. I will give it as 12. Okay. Once you create it, give okay. This is how you can create. And if you want to add, you can add. If you want to remove, if you remove, it will create a blade. See, like this. Got it? Any doubts? Yes,
sir. No, sir.
So this is very important. So next, so this is all about the part design. So next I will show you one example how to create a solid models by using orthographic drawings. So let me open the drawing. So I will show you one example. So this is very important. Okay. So what you have to do? So you have to use orthographic drawings to create 3D model. You have to use 2D drawings to create 3D model. I will show you how to read the drawing. So I will just open. So we have many drawings. So in that, I will show you which is having all the three views. Okay, this. Okay, so all of you are getting this drawing.
No, sir, we are not getting.
So this word file you are not getting. So here this one.
It is getting, sir.
Yeah, it's getting. That one is getting.
Yeah. So now, okay. So can you observe this drawing? So first, so here, so this is top view, this is side view, okay? You need to be thorough with angles of projections. So do you know what is angles of projections? Anybody? What is angles of projection? Don't know. So we have first angle, third angle, and first angle, second angle, third and fourth angle of projection, right? All of you are getting my voice or not?
Yes, sir, getting, sir.
So do you know first, second, third, fourth angle of projection?
No, sir.
No. What this is the basic thing. For all mechanical engineering students. So you just refer by yourself. See, first angle of projection and third angle of projection we are using. So we are not using second and fourth angle of projection. Okay. So in first angle of projection, top view will be in the bottom side, bottom view will be in the top side, right side view will be in the left side view will be in the right side. But in when it comes to third angle of projection, so top view will remain in top side itself, bottom will be in the bottom side, right side, see all remains in the, views remains in the same position. So here, this is front view, this is top view. Which angle of projection is this? First angle of projection, okay? So you just observe, see imagination is very important. So if this is a front view, this is a top view, this is a side view. So from where we can start? So first what we'll do, see, observe carefully, this is very important. So first we'll create this triangle, or else we can create this also, or this. So first what I'll do is follow this procedure. So I will create this triangle in a front plane. So select the front plane, go to position sketch and give OK. Now go to profile. So what I will do, I'll create this triangle. Okay. Now we need to constrain it. So how to constrain, what is the height he has given from this point to this? How much? What is the distance? What is the distance?
84.
Then what is the distance between this and this? What is the distance?
96.
Yeah, 96. See here, if you project, you will get 86. So select this and this. 86. So it is going somewhere. What we need to do in this case? See, it is moving like this. So how
it's to... 96, no?
96 or 86?
96.
So here, how to constrain this? Chandan, how to constrain this?
Sir, only the length, not rectangle.
Sir,
Sir,
from descent to from middle, sir, like we can able to give like half, we can able to do, sir, like 96 divided by 2.
We can do, but we can do this also, na. Select this, this point, right click allow symmetry, vertical axis. Now,
yes, sir.
Okay, so once you do this, exit. See here, you are getting a front view and pad. So how to pad? So better you use, see here we have symmetrical, right? Use mirror. So what is the depth of this? So here we have 72. Okay, so we need to give how much? 72 divided by 2. See, now we have got, right? All of you are getting. So next, which part we will create? So this, so we'll create this, you will get this. So for that, I will select this middle plane. See here, select the middle plane and I will go to sketch. Now we'll create the entire thing of this. So go to rectangle, first create it. Then first we'll make a symmetry this. Right click. Allow symmetry with respect to this. Now, what is the distance of this? Total distance from here to here, 192.
192.
Yeah. Next, what is the height of this?
36.
Now we have done, right? Next, exit. So once you exit, go to pad. So again, we need to use mirror extent. So what is the distance of this? 48. 48 divided by 2. See now. So now if you go to front view here, so you are getting same representation. If you go to top view, you are getting this representation, right? So now, which is the next part?
Hole.
Hole. So this hole. So what I will do? So I will use insert body. I will select this. So now, see here, it is positioning somewhere like this. So in this case, what you can do, I will select this plane. So, but if I want to position this model, should be in this, horizontal should be here, right? I'll just make a swap. Horizontal has come here. Vertical has to go upward. Just make it reverse. See now, it has been positioned as per your requirement. Sir, same as this. Now, use circle. So go to circle, here we will create hole. What is the dia of this?
Twenty-four.
Next, how to constrain this? How to constrain this? Which dimension should we give? Mm-hmm. Huh? 24, right? From center point to this,
24.
So exit. So you directly can use pocket by creating two profiles, but I am showing you how to, where you are going to apply this Boolean operation and all. So go to pad. So use mirror extend. So extend this and give okay. After that, go to mirror, select this, give us, and select the plane and give okay. Next, right click on the body too and remove it. See, like this. So if you go to top view, you have got a hole. Next, we have a slot here, right here. So what you have to do? We will select this. I need to position like this. So go to position sketch, make a swap, and make reverse hatch. And give OK. Now, just create it and make symmetry. Right click, allow symmetry with respect to vertical axis. All of you getting? So what is the distance of this? 24. Next, what is the height? See, from here to here, that is
21.
Yeah, don't worry about this dimension because nothing is there to do there. So use pocket, use mirror extent, and give OK. So now again we have a hole here, right? So select it, go to position sketch, give OK. And if you want to create a hole here, just create it. What is the dia? 12. That is through hole, right? Exit.
Yeah.
Go to pocket and remove it. See? This is how you can create. If you go to front view, so you'll get this representation. See, here we have shaded with material. So if you use this, you'll get the hidden lines also. If you go to top view, see, then if you go to side view, you'll get this. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you just practice these things. I will share the models. So all of you submit some of the drawings. I will send you. So tomorrow I will show you how to start project, and I will assign the projects also. Start doing this. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
So shall I wind up the session?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.